This is Darvill and Joe. We're going to try and tell you about some pictures we took a long, long time ago of our family and kids. Of course, I'm sure you recognize these. That's Mac and John and their cycles. This was taken in Solomonville, where I was the principal of the school part.
Mac was about three and John was about two.
And that's my beautiful wife, John. Looks like the wind was blowing.
This background are all Mexican-built buildings. They're lived in by white people, but Mexican-built.
This is Marvin, Garvin, a friend who lives across the way and down the street a ways. He belongs to Rose Hansen in our region. He and Mac are pretty good friends. Now they had to show off their swimming togs. Togs.
John always thought it was bashful.
This little truck was really a
little fire truck.
A great baby tender. Let's see, what year was this, Joe? About 19...
This dog is Darby.
That's Darby.
Mac was three, and there's Sally, about 5 months old.
Like Joe said, these buildings around here are the old Mexican type. Some of them are adobe, but not all. I don't know what the rabbit's name was.
This dog belonged to my brother, Virgil and Toots, and when they moved, they loved him so we had to take him along with us because they couldn't have him.
Mike's sitting here with us, helping us on this. He has a question why we invite him to ask it.
We'll let him open his mouth. This was the back of porch of the back of our house.
It wasn't our house, it was rented house.
And right behind it was a big canal. These are my little Oki clothes.
Too bad Sally wasn't quite big enough to walk. She could get around in this, or even crawl, to get in this picture.
Oh, darling Lucille. She lived with her aunt because her mother lived in Miami.
Well,
and she had her aunt and uncle own Shorty's Cafe. Everybody loved their Mexican food. But she didn't have a place to sleep, and we loved her. She was
she
so
lived
dainty.
With us for what? One whole school year, didn't she? Helped with the kids.
Dainty and darling.
She and her husband later came to our 50th wedding anniversary in Pasadena.
Maybe you met them, Mike. She was very small. They had one son with them. He was very short.
That's a teeter-totter I built. My own idea. Now, Sally's gotten a little bigger now. This is a house that I built during one summer. Did practically everything myself except make the adobes and do the plastering and the electrical work. Did practically everything else.
We were having Western days and they have their Western clothes on. Oh, weren't they cute?
This is a school parade on, what was the occasion? Was this, this wasn't Easter, what, Easter?
It was around November, I think. Maybe our Mistress
Day. Now that's Sally, she's the queen of the parade. And we got a few pictures of the parade. It's quite long, but we just cut in and showing you a few pictures of the parade where our own kids are in it.
Darvel was principal of the school in Solomon at this time. Now we're in the desert on the way to California. A fabulous vacation.
I got too much sunlight, I guess, or don't have enough background in the pictures.
That was one of the All-American Canal views, wasn't it?
Yes, that was one of the big canal of water from the Colorado River going to California.
Can you believe
your grandmother
ever was that thin?
Or are your grandfather either?
Oh, he always was real thin till Mama cooked for him for a while.
Yeah, we got to climb to the top of that sand dune now. It's going to take a little doing. These are sand dunes just out of San Diego, just out of Yuma as you come toward San Diego.
And because of the rain, they were fairly well packed. Easy to go up and down without getting too sandy. Don't see much of these anymore. They've planted rows of salt cedar trees along, and I'm sure out of ways they're still there, but along the highway they aren't.
This original film was taken with a 16 millimeter camera. This is where we stayed after we'd reached our destination on our vacation trip.
In San Diego at Mission Beach.
This is out on a pier.
All these cottages go all the way out over the ocean on the pier. It was really a gorgeous place for us.
Pier was too high for you to fall off from, I'm telling you that.
Except the kids were down and John got carried away by a wave and really was frightening. We got him all right, but there's the end of the pier past where the cottages were.
Now we lived in this last cottage for what, 5 days?
I guess. Not long enough.
This is in Newport Beach.
That's Maud and Glenn, Jim's mother and father.
Jim is in this picture.
That's Jim right there, right by me.
I don't know whether we'll see it again or not. That's Glenn. That's Maud, Porter.
Sand in the eyes. Oh, they love that sand.
That's Esther Williams.
Mike can tell. But our kids were all real fair and the boys especially always had burned noses. So that's why Mac had that stuff on his nose to keep it from blistering more. Who is that in the water?
But we thought this was great stuff then. It doesn't mean much to us anymore. We
oh, it does.
Live by the ocean so long.
I loved it. I love it now. John. Almost got a picture of the gym there with his mother.
Oh, we had to take him to the zoo.
What park is? It won't come to my head.
San Diego Zoo.
This was a zoo, but the buildings at this zoo and the animals were put there for a fair, wasn't it? A World's Fair?
Yeah, a World's Fair held in San Diego.
Balboa Zoo.
Balboa Zoo. Balboa Park.
Balboa Park. Big old hippo. Big old polar. No, he's not a polar. No. He's a brown bear, isn't he?
Yeah. Brown
anyway,
or
he's
black.
A bear. Coaxing for peanuts.
Yeah, they want you to throw them. That's a grizzly. He had hump on his shoulder. That's a grizzly.
Big raw bones. Okay.
There's your polar.
Okay. John and Danielle took us to the Cincinnati Zoo when we were there about 2 or 3 years ago. And we saw this gorgeous animal, what was it? So lying on the ground, that big.
Tiger.
One of the biggest tigers in all
tiger.
The world. They said there was another one there too. We just saw the one. Oh, he was monstrous. Pigeons, parrots. Mac always wanted everything to eat out of his hands. I don't know whether there's a picture in this, him coaxing the peacocks.
And a peacock and a pigeon.
Love both of us. Love. Look at the baby on that back. Can you see it, Mike?
I guess kids love monkeys. I think this is the
pigeon
Mac's going to try to feed. Anyway, I think he tries to feed one of them. Well, this is that huge gorilla.
Huge, and he ate so differently. We gave him a banana, and he didn't gobble it down like you'd think an animal would. He took it in his one paw, or hand, and peeled it with the other and ate it and threw the peeling away. Exotic birds.
Here's Mac and Fico.
That's your granddaddy. Granddaddy Mac when he was your size.
She was talking to Sandy. Sandy's just come in.
And there's Aunt Sally.
Well, here we are back in Solomon again.
Is that K?
Yeah, that's K.
Right, K Odell. K. That was my daddy back then.
This is Marvin, Mac's friend. He's grown up a little since the last time we saw him.
He's our old dog.
And you saw the little car sitting there. That's a little Chevrolet. Belongs to Joe's mother, Minnie.
Oh, then it was Dad, too. Dad's, too.
Yeah.
In a minute, you'll get to see me. That's my daddy, see? That's your great-great-granddaddy. And that's my mama, your great-great-mama, Nettie. And Jean, her, my little sister. Oh, she's precious. See, aren't they gorgeous?
Everybody in Thatcher knew Dave and Nettie. There's Kay and Sally. Just picture the Grand Mountains.
That your granddaddy Darvill loves.
My brother Leonard worked on the Grand Mountains for 30-something years as a guard and a ranger.
That's granddaddy Darvill.
He said he didn't...
Matt, your granddaddy.
He didn't know what heaven was like, but he hoped there was a Grand Mountain in it.
Yeah,
snow. I didn't go. Did I go on this trip? I can't remember.
Yeah.
Some of them I didn't go on. Granddaddy wrapped the kids' feet in burlap so they wouldn't get too cold.
And Sally had to get hurt. Feelings hurt. Oh, decided to make a snowman.
Cold to me. That's your granddaddy.
I'm so nice.
Now there is Granddaddy Darvill's mama. And his brother's wife and her two little kids.
That was Evelyn. Evelyn was mother.
With Evelyn Joy in Orlando.
Evelyn Joy. She had two. Orlando now is bishop over at Ajo.
That little boy.
And Evelyn Joy is married in Safford, got a family of four or five.
Well, three of them are married, maybe more.
That's Evelyn and Darvill's mother.
That's a darling picture of Grandmother Clara.
Well, this is the bike you were talking about.
That's Dick Cammer. Dickie Cammer. That's Granny Joe there, I think.
Well, what is this occasion, Joe? Do you know?
No, I haven't found it yet. There's you.
Yeah, that's me.
You've put on 2 or 3 pounds by then.
Yeah, getting a little more meat on me.
And that's your grandma, Granny Jo, with her sister's husband, Scott.
Scott Merrill.
There's Uncle John.
And that was Scott.
There's Aunt Eleanor. That was Eleanor. Granny Jo's sister.
And her mother.
And my mama.
Eleanor dad died just a few years ago.
Scott died quite a long time ago. And this is their, that's Marilyn.
Yeah, that's Marilyn.
And this is a friend of Marilyn's. one of them belonged to my sister and to this couple.
That's
and
Suzanne.
That's Suzanne, and she belonged to them too. They had two girls. And that's grandmother Clara.
This is my mother at her house in Thatcher. She loved this place and her flowers. And until the day before she died, she worked in the flowers.
And around the back, she had a Swiss chard plot. She never did come to eat with us, but well, she brought us a big mess of Swiss chard all cleaned ready to cook.
That's the front of her house, you see. That was the highway right out in front of our house in Thatcher.
And this is our house. And that's Granny Joe's brother, Rodney. He's the one that died. He's carrying his little boy, David, his baby boy. And that's Evelyn Joy in Orlando there.
Yeah.
And this must be Michael over here. There's Sally Joe. Can't hardly recognize my own kids.
It's a little dim.
That is Michael, isn't it? Yes, with her braids.
Yeah,
oh,
that's Michael.
And that's Grandmother Nettie, Granny Joe's mama, carrying Rodney's baby David. Little Rodney right there. Where's Janice? I haven't seen her.
She's around. She's here.
Is that Janice there? I think that's her. Yes, that's Janice. They just took David. Joe and Rodney. Sally and Evelyn Joy. Sally. Eleanor. Those are sweet pictures of Eleanor. This must have been on a Mother's Day, Darvel, because I mean, we were down there.
I forget the occasion exactly. Christmas Day, 1949. And baloney, too, I guess.
And Janice always was crippled. Later she lost her leg before she died. She was so patient. That's Kay and Sally Joe. Rodney getting Janice into the car. Kay is their oldest, and she and Sally Joe loved each other because they were the same age. Here's Michael with her Christmas doll.
Yeah, Kay and Sally showing off their femininities.
Now that's John on that motorbike there, wasn't it?
I think it was.
Rodney, Eleanor.
There's Shorty.
Oh, you should know Shorty.
Shorty would fight anything you'd tell him to. Give him a rock or a brick or whatever it was, and he'd fight it.
He belonged to Eleanor and Scott.
And all you had to do was just
he lost his
keep
teeth, so
edging him on, and he'd fight that off.
That's Marilyn, Mama.
Boy.
Suzanne. Glenn Battle. Jean.
Was this before or after
this
they were married?
Darling.
There's a... There's Shorty fighting
a rock. He was a little stray dog they picked up, but they think he must have come from a circus or something. He was so smart and cute. That's Kay. Cafe. That's Tally on the five. Michael. Mac. Your granddaddy again. Sally and Kay. Was it Jean?
There's the master.
That's who said.
Now we're going to take you on a backpack. Or not a backpack, a packing trip. We're going to go into the mountains or spend two nights, maybe three, which was it? I think it was two nights with a couple that we'd made friends with. He was a teacher at the Solomonville School where I was principal. And he and his wife and Joe and I, we decided
there's
on this.
Mac and John. And if you look, you'll see Sally Jokerson, a school teacher, was going to stay at our home with them while we four adults were. There's Sally.
We had to get that burro packed. And to be sure that pack stayed on, I had to throw the diamond hitch.
He's going to teach Mike how. So Mike can teach his Boy Scouts. That's our house right behind the horses there that Darvel built. And there's the...
There comes the heart woman.
School teacher with her that stayed with the kids, Miss Brown. She was so dear.
That's Hilda. Hilda. Wife of our the school teacher here. That's
well, I got
Richard,
on the horse better than Hilda did, and she
Richard
was
and Hilda Taylor. Richard, he's a real horseman. He's raised on a ranch. And that's a well-packed burro.
That's Granny Joe on the horse.
This is about a 10-mile trip.
We head
no, I guess it's not quite that far. Eight, probably.
Head straight.
About 8 miles.
North of the mountains. There's Sally Joe and Miss Brown and John. Max probably back up the road.
There's our house sitting to the left. Now, the first adventure would be to cross the Gila River. The Gila River runs through the Gila Valley, naturally. Now we've left the road and take the trail. He doesn't need leading anymore. He knows that he's to pack that pack where we want him to go, so he takes off.
This was made more than 50 years ago.
There's the pass we're heading for. We have to get through that pass, go down into Benet Creek. That's where that was our destination, was to get to Benet.
Lots of manzanita along this trail. Now we're in the mesquite, aren't we?
Yeah, we're still going to lower elevations. Of course, we never get to a high elevation on this mountain. This is the mountain that's north of our valley. The Grim Mountains are south of the valley. They're high mountains. These are low mountains. You get a few pines in these mountains. Mostly cedars and oak, sycamore.
The creek was beautiful and running quite a stream. Didn't some of the Safford water come from?
Yeah, the same creek came from a different part of where we were. But came from the same creek. Still headed for the pass. Trying to think of the name of that pass. Do you remember?
I wouldn't remember. When we get down to the bottom of this, there's a creek. And my horse got to that creek, he started to lie down. It scared me to death because I was still on his back. Boy, I really scrambled. There's the creek. Sycamores, rocks, water.
These cliffs, there are some cliff dwellings. I don't remember whether I got a good shot of the cliff dwellings or not. It's just a big opening, cave-like opening in the side of the cliff wall. Yeah, that's part of them. Part of them you can see up there. They're right under the rim. There's several of them along there. And most of them, you can't get to them except to be let down from above with a rope.
Pretty soon we camp and this by this creek, and that's where the men cook dinner.
We go through what's called a Midnight Canyon. It's just wide enough for a horse to get through. And you see how high those walls are. And some, it gets so dark in there in some places that you had to turn on the headlights.
He's a pretty good photographer, isn't he, Mike?
Real rough going. Finally made camp. I think we're preparing our first meal.
Garvel's the biscuit maker. Gilda, she's sweet.
There's one of the tents.
Did you tell me a story about those pants, Granny Joe, that you're wearing?
Those trousers are my going away clothes for my honeymoon. We had a camp, Darla fixed us a camp in the mountains when we were married. So after I got out of my white satin wedding dress, I put those on to go to the mountains. And I wore them while we were up there for the whole time. It was really, our honeymoon was really my first camping bit.
Richard Taylor, he loved horses. And he made a bargain with me after he tasted my first batch of Dutch oven biscuits. Well, he made a bargain with me. He says, you make the biscuits every morning, noon, and night, and I'll take care of the horses.
Thank you. And he did, and they were always delicious.
Horses?
Nah, the horses are pretty ornery sometimes.
Granddaddy Darvel even knew how to make pie and cobblers in the Dutch oven, besides frying fried foods and eggs and bacon and what else? Potatoes.
Well, it looks like we're
cinching up.
We're gonna head for home. Which we couldn't do until we found the burro. We hobbled the burro. Well, we hobbled the horses too. But we couldn't find the burro that morning. We were gonna come home. And we went all up and down the canyon looking for him. And got back to camp and looked up on a little hill, kind of a knoll-like down in the creek bed. And kind of behind bushes and trees, and there stood the burro. Still had his hobbles on, and he was only a few rods from camp. Beautiful creek.
Yes, it was a beautiful creek and beautiful time. It was Easter time, wasn't it, Darvel? And the weather was delightful.
Yeah, I guess it was Easter.
There we are, heading uphill.
Make the climb back out of the creek, down through the pass, back down again to the Gila River, and then home. And we bid you goodbye.